Hello students, welcome back once again. In the last class we have been discussing about nomenclature of organic compounds.
Correct.
Mostly we were discussing about hydrocarbons and their naming. Okay. Today we shall continue our discussion on nomenclature, in which we will practice some more questions which are related to nomenclature. Let us take some examples. I am writing here only the condensed forms. Okay, this is a compound where CH3 CH2 CH2 CH3, since the by numbering 1 2 3 4 we get butane. Correct. This already you have studied. Okay, now children, look at this compound. Here, if you look at the straight chain, there are 1 2 3 4 carbon atoms and two branching are there. Correct. So, but according to the rule of IUPAC nomenclature, what is IUPAC? IUPAC means International Union for Pure and Applied Chemistry. Okay, this IUPAC only sets how to name or what are the rules to be used in naming the compound, all those things. Okay, so according to IUPAC nomenclature, so we have to find the longest continuous chain. Here if you go from this way, 1 2 3 4 5 6, this comes the longest chain. So we can say going this way you get the longest chain instead of going straight. Okay, so here we get a 6 numbered chain, that is our 6 means hex comes, and since it is a single bonded you can write any. Now but there are 2 substituents comes here in the 3rd and 4th position, so that has to be mentioned as 3 4. There are 2 methyl groups, so we write it as dimethyl. Okay, so 2,3-dimethylhexane is the name of the compound. Children, you must remember, if there is only 1 methyl group, no need to mention this di here. Okay, since there are 2 methyl groups, that's why we have mentioned it as 2,4-dimethylhexane. Suppose if there were, instead of this particular place, if we had one more CH3, okay, then the name will again change. This 3,3 you have to mention here, third position, this is the third position in the carbon, there are 2 CH3 groups. Okay, so we have to mention 3,3, and in the fourth position also there is a methyl group, but this has to be changed in diet into try. Why? Because there are 1, 2, 3 methyl groups are there. So the name will be changed according to the number of substituents present in it. Clear? So this will come 3,3,4-trimethylhexane. Understood? Next we shall study about other than hydrocarbon like methyl, ethyl groups, if any other species comes in the compound. Let us see that. That is CH3, CH2, 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 CH3. This is our normal pentane. Suppose if any one of the places, suppose if bromine is there. Okay. And one more place, suppose in the other place also there is a CH3 species. Now this bromine, you know, this is a halogen derivative. We have studied in the functional group it has a halo derivative. So this will be spelled as bromo. Okay, bromo derivative. Okay, so and this is our methyl group. Since it is not part of the parent chain will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is the parent chain. Parent chain is our pentane only. Correct. Now these two are the substituents only. This bromine halogen compounds are not main functional groups, so they are also taken as substituents only. They will be written before the parent chain's name. Okay, that is since bromine B is coming before M according to the alphabetical order, we can write the positional number as 2-bromo. Then third position we have 3-methyl. Then pentane. So you understood? This is the second place bromine is there, that's why it is 2-bromo, and in the third position we have methyl group, that's why it is 3-methyl and pentane. Here we have not used di and tri because this bromine and methyl groups are different groups, isn't it? So we have not used that one. Okay, now if there are actually functional groups are present, that is main functional groups, like let me take an example. This is this carbon in which suppose OH is also present. Children, you know what is the name of what is the meaning of OH group? OH group is actually alcoholic group, isn't it? Alcoholic functional group is OH. Okay, so OH you cannot write as a substituent. OH is actually a main functional group only. So the name will not come simply as a pentane. So instead of pentane, E will be dropped, and where that alcoholic group is there, that positional number will be written along with that the name will be written. That is, since it is a pentane in the second position, it is there, so pentane 2-ol. But you have to also mention their names, that is the second position bromo is there, so you write 2-bromo, then 3-methyl, 2-bromo, 3-methyl, pentane 2-ol. Okay, since it is in the second position, OH group is there, you cannot write pentane, it has to be written as pentane 2-ol. Why? Because alcoholic functional group comes in the second position, that's why we have mentioned 2-ol. If it was in the first position, you have nothing to do, you have to give the you can simply write it as pentane 1-ol or pentanol. Pentanol is understood that it is in the first position only. Okay, so you have to also use the 2 over here in order to mention that OL is the OH group is present in the second position. Clear it is? Next, let us take another example. Next we have children, look at this compound. Here, this terminal end of this carbon, we are having a CHO group. This is actually a functional group. What is this CHO means? CHO is an aldehyde group. But children, one thing you have to remember here is this aldehyde functional group where carbon is also part of it. But when numbering the compound for nomenclature, you have to consider this carbon also, and you have to give preference to that carbon. Okay, the first number one must be given to that carbon where that functional group is there. Then 2, 3, 4, 5, like that you have to number. So this is actually 5 membered carbon, so it is of course a pentane only, but pentane, the aldehyde group, we write it as pentanol. What is the name comes? Pentanol. Suppose we have in the second position there is a methyl substituent is there. Okay, so what do we write this as? This will be written as in the second position CH3 is there, so we will write it as 2-methyl pentanol. Okay, so when a functional groups in which carbon itself is there, numbering will be done from that particular carbon atom which includes the functional group. Okay, next another example let us take. Children, look at this carbon bond here. Simply when you look, you may think that okay, this has OH also, double bond holds. Okay, but this whole thing is our carboxylic acid functional group. Okay, and suppose somewhere here there is another functional group like halo substitution, that is our chlorine is there. Okay, then how do we name this compound, let us see. So first preference must be given to this carbon, where you have to start numbering in that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Remember children, only carbon will be numbered, not the other group. This is OH is there, don't put a number on OH. Okay, this OH is not alcohol, this is actually part of this whole functional group. This is a carboxylic functional group only. So the parent chain is our hexane, in which E will be dropped. Okay, and since it is acid, we will write hexanoic acid. So oic acid is the name, oic acid is the name which has to be inserted instead of, which has to be replaced instead of ene. Okay, this becomes a hexanoic acid, but we have a substituent in the third position, that is the water, chlorine. So what we will write, 3-chloro hexanoic acid. Okay children, did you understand? This is the IUPAC nomenclature of an acid functional group. Okay, understood? Let's see another example here. In this particular compound, see, this is the main functional group, C double bond O. But children, what is C double bond O? C double bond O is a ketonic functional group, correct? As well as we have a bromine substitution is here. Here another, what we have is the methyl group, okay? So according to the nomenclature, first of all, you have to see the longest continuous chain, isn't it? There is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 carbon atoms are there, so we can say it is our hexane. So since it is a ketonic functional group, you have to write it as hexane, in which E has to be removed, and hexane, in which position ketone is there, second position. Okay, then hexane 2 on must be written. This is on ketones ONE has to be replaced with that E. Okay, so hexane 2 on. Now the substituents where and where it is present, it is present both in the third position only, so you have to mention that as 3-bromo then 3-methyl. Both are in the third position only, that's why I have written 3-bromo 3-methyl, then 6 carbon atoms are there, that's why I have mentioned that hexane. Then instead of ANE, we have to write hexane 2 on. Okay children, I hope you understood this. Practice some more questions which are given in the refreshers and all, and try to improve your understanding in nomenclature. And if you are having any doubts, please put it in the comment box and let me know. Okay children, thank you and have a nice day.
Thank you.